Good morning, children. Let us begin with Standard 4 English Grammar. Unit 6, the adverb, kinds of adverbs. So what is an adverb? An adverb is a word which adds to the meaning of a verb and tells us how a thing is done, when it is done, or where it is done. Now, what is adverb? From the word itself, add something to the verb. So we say it is an adverb. So a word that explains and gives us some more information about our action word, that is the verb. So we say that is the adverb. Now, for example, see the first one. The bird sang sweetly. The second is Hari came yesterday. Third, the sun shines everywhere. So the verb in the first sentence is sang. It is showing an action. So we say, ask how she sang. So she sang very sweetly. The second verb is came in the second sentence. So came when? Yesterday. The third, the verb is shines. Shines where? Everywhere. So these words, they are adding something to the verb. So we say that these are the adverbs. So sweetly, yesterday, everywhere are the adverbs. Now, as we learned, in nouns, we have different kinds of nouns. Verbs, we have two types. The same way, there are different kinds of adverbs. So let us read these sentences. The first one is, she behaved foolishly. Your second one, the old man walked slowly. Your third one, she ran fast. Fourth, the boys rode well. Fifth, the soldiers fought bravely. Sixth, Sita writes neatly. So now here your verbs in the first sentence was behaved. So we say asked, behaved how? So we get the answer foolishly. Now the old man walked is your verb. Walked how? Slowly. Third, ran how? Fast. The boys rode how? Well. The soldiers fought how? Bravely. Sita writes how? Neatly. So all these words, when we asked a question how, we got an answer. So we got that answer related to the verb. And these words, they were saying something more about the verb. So we say that when we ask a question how and we get any answer to the verb, we say that these words are adverbs and they are adverb of manner. So adverb of manner, when we need to find out, we have to ask a question how to the verbs, add verb. So first thing, we need to find the verb in the sentence and then ask the question how. So if we get any answer, then we say that it is the adverb of manner. So the adverbs foolishly, slowly, well, fast, bravely, neatly show how or in what manner in which an action is done. So such adverbs are called adverbs of manner. Adverbs of manner answer the question how. So when we have to find out different adverbs in the sentence, the first question that you need to ask your verb is how. And if you get any answer, so which adverb will it be? Adverb of manner. So here's one exercise. Here are some adverbs of manner given to us in the block and we need to fill in the blanks. So which adverbs are given? Quickly, greedily, merrily, loudly and brightly. So do you find anything same in all these words? They are mostly ending in ly, ly, ly. So most of the words which end in ly are mostly adverbs of manner. Not always, but mostly. So now let us read these sentences and fill in the blanks. The first one. The hungry beggar ate the food greedily. Greedily means one after the other. He was very hungry. So greedily. Second, I had to shout loudly to attract her attention. Third, Tony climbed the trees as quickly as a monkey. Fourth, there were no clouds and the sun shone brightly. Fifth, all the day the children played merrily in the park. So all these are adverbs of manner. Ate how? Greedily. Shouted how? Loudly. Climbed how? Quickly. Shone how? Brightly. Played how? Merrily. So all are answering the question how, and so they are adverbs of manner. Now let's study the adverbs in these sentences. Your first sentence is, the boys are waiting outside. Your second one, we looked for her everywhere. Third, he lives here. Fourth, the bus stops there. Fifth, my brother has gone out. Sixth, the boys ran forward. So now here, the adverbs outside, everywhere, here, there, out and forward show where an action is done. So such adverbs are called adverbs of place. They answer, adverb of place answer the question where. So now in the above sentences, which was your verb in the first sentence? Are waiting. So when we ask the question, where are the boys waiting? So we get the answer outside. Second, we looked where? We looked everywhere. Lives where? Here. Stops where? There. Has gone where? Out. Ran where? Forward. So whenever we ask the question where and we get any answer, we say it shows the place and we say that it is an adverb of place. So your first adverb you learned, adverb of manner, and your second adverb was adverb of place. Now let's see the third one. So again, let us read these sentences. He will come today. She wrote to me yesterday. The school will open tomorrow. He came here daily. She left early. She will come presently. The doctor is coming immediately. So here the adverbs are which? Today, yesterday, tomorrow, daily, early, presently, immediately. They show when an action is done. Such adverbs are called adverbs of time. Now adverbs of time, they answer the question when. So now see your first sentence, that is the verb is will come. Will come when? Today. Wrote when? Yesterday. Will open when? Tomorrow. Will come when? Daily. Left when? Early. Will come when? Presently. Is coming when? Immediately. So these words are answering the question when. So now when these answers we get by asking the question when, we know that they are adverbs of time. So which three now you learnt? Adverb of manner, adverb of place, and adverb of time. Now let's read these sentences. Twice the boy struck him. Second, you are always late. Third, we often went to the cinema. Fourth, he seldom came here. Fifth, she visited us once. So the adverbs twice, always, often, seldom and once show how often an action is done. How often means repeatedly, how many times it is done. So such adverbs are called adverbs of number. Adverbs of number answer the question how often. So in the first sentence, struck was your verb. So struck how often? Twice. Are late how often? Always. Went how often? Often.
Came how often? Seldom. Seldom means once in a blue moon or only sometimes is seldom. Visited us how often? So once. So these are answering the question how often, and they are adverbs of number. Now another set of sentences. First one, he was very tired. He was quite worn out. He was nearly exhausted. He is entirely deaf. He was somewhat pleased. Now each of the adverbs here, very, quiet, nearly, entirely, somewhat, in the above sentences show how much or to what extent a thing is done. So these adverbs which show how much or to what extent a thing is done are called adverbs of degree. Adverbs of degree answer the question how much. Now the first sentence, see, your verb was. How much he was tired? He was very tired. Some extent it is showing, very tired. Again, was worn out, how much? Quite worn out. Was exhausted, how much? Nearly. Exhausted is also tired. Nearly. Is deaf, how much? Entirely, means he's completely deaf. And was pleased, how much? Somewhat. So, these are called adverbs of degree. What question we asked? How much? So, now which adverbs we have learnt? Adverb of manner, adverb of place, adverb of time, adverb of number, and this was adverb of degree. So this was your fifth adverb. Now see the second set of sentences. He is quite strong. Her face is very beautiful. Your face is extremely red. She was almost hungry. The glass was nearly full. In these above sentences, the adverbs quite, very, extremely, almost and nearly, which are used with adjectives that are strong, beautiful, red, angry and full, to add something to their meaning are also called adverbs of degree. Now these words which we just read, they are also adverbs, but they are showing something more about an adjective. So, but here they are used as adverbs. So, these are also adverbs of degree. Now, read these sentences. First one, when did he come? Second, where did he go? Third, how are you today? Fourth, why are you late? So, in these sentences, the words when, where, how and why are used for asking questions. Adverbs which are used to ask questions are called interrogative adverbs. So how will you know in the sentence that it is an interrogative adverb? Interrogative means always asking questions, and end of the sentence you will find a question mark. And your first word like when, where, how, why, we know that these are asking questions, WH words. They are mostly asking questions. So they are our interrogative adverbs. So in total we have 6 adverbs. Now exercise 2, we have to underline the adverb in the following sentences. We have to put a tick mark in the correct column to show what kind of an adverb is it. And you have to circle the verbs with which the adverb is connected. So what kind it is, manner, time or place, that in that block we need to tick. And in that way we have to do this exercise. We will underline the adverbs and the verbs first. So see, the first one is done for you. We went to the concert yesterday. Now went is your verb, so we have circled it. And went when? Yesterday. So yesterday is your adverb, we need to underline. And when gives you which adverb? Adverb of time. So we put a tick mark in that block. Now the second one. My father sat comfortably on the sofa and read the paper. Now your verb is sat, so you need to circle. Sat how? Comfortably. So you get that adverb of manner. So tick in manner. Third one, you must go out and see who rang the bell. Now your verb is go. So you circle it. Go where? Out. So out you need to underline. And question where will give you adverb of place. So tick in that place block. Fourth one, the dogs follow his master faithfully. Follows is your verb. So you circle it. Follow how? Faithfully. So underline faithfully, and that is adverb of manner. You tick it in that block. Fifth one, go and bring the chair here. Bring is your verb. You circle. Bring where? Here. Here is your adverb. So you need to take in the place block. Then the sixth one. The doctor is coming immediately. Is coming is your verb. Circle it. Is coming when? Immediately. So that is adverb of time. So take in adverb of time. Seventh one. All the bedrooms are upstairs. So are is your verb. You circle. Are where? Upstairs. So upstairs is the place. Take in place. The eighth one. How beautifully she is dressed. So is dressed is your verb. You need to circle. Is dressed how? Beautifully. So it will be adverb of manner. You tick in the first block. Ninth one. She met with an accident there. Met is your verb. You circle. Met where? There. So underline there. There is adverb of place. Tenth. The old woman spent her money foolishly. Spent is your verb. Spent how? Foolishly. So foolishly you have to underline, and that is your adverb of manner. Now exercise 3. We have to read these sentences. Label the underlying verbs which tell how often with H-O and those that tell how long with H-L. The first one is done for you. For example, the adverbs are underlined in the sentences. We need to underline them, and then we have to say whether it is talking about how often or how long. If it is how long, we have to write HL, and if it is how often, we need to write HO. So for example, the first one, it is very important to always obey school rules. So always is your adverb. So this is showing that how often we need to obey the school rule. It is a degree. So it shows HO. How often? So we need to write the H-O. In the same manner, we need to do the rest of the sentences. Your second sentence, some students break the rules daily and do not listen to anyone. So your adverb you need to underline is daily. This also shows how often the children are doing that. So again, this is H-O.
Now these are the rest of our sentences. Let us complete them. Now the third one, they frequently come late to school and are often punished for this. So here there are two adverbs, frequently and often, that you need to underline, and both show how often we are doing this. So you have to write H-O in both. Fourth one, the principal reminds us weekly that we should always be punctual. So again, there are two adverbs, weekly and always. You need to underline. And again, they show how often we are supposed to do these. So they are how often, and you need to write H-O. Fifth one, but the boys do not pay attention to what he says even for 10 seconds. 10 seconds is showing that how long they remember. So this will be H-L. Now exercise 4. Let us test whether you can find the difference between an adverb or an adjective. The first one are done for you. So now let's see the first one. What we have to do. Who is that little girl? Now little is given to us. Now it is an adjective. Why? Because it is describing the noun girl. In the same second one, it is given. He spoke little. Now same again little. But here this little is saying something more about the verb spoke. So here little will be an adverb. Okay. So in that way we have to read the sentences. The same words will be an adverb also an adjective. So where it is an adverb and where it is an adjective that we need to find out. So in the same manner we do the rest of the sentences. Same words are given. In one place it will be an adverb and in the other place it will be an adjective. So that we need to understand and do the needful. So in the same manner we do the rest of the sentences. So your third one is the boy of our school can run fast. So here fast is what? It is an adverb. How he can run? He can run fast. So it is giving more, saying something more about the verb run. Fourth one. Roshan is a fast runner. Now here fast is an adjective. Why? Because it is telling something more about the noun runner. They are the same words, but one fast is saying something about the verb and one fast is saying something about the noun. Now the fifth one. Anirosh is the only son of his parents. So now here only. Only is an adjective. It is saying something more about the noun son. Now the same one, do not get angry. I only wanted to help you. So here only is an adverb. It is saying something more about the verb wanted. The seventh one, it is good for health to jog daily. Now daily is an adverb. It is saying something more about the verb jog. Eighth one, there are now daily flights from Delhi to Singapore. Now here daily is what? It is an adjective. Why? Because it is saying something more about the noun flight. The ninth one, they buy magazines which appear weekly. Now here weekly is an adverb because it is saying something more about the verb appear. Appear when? Weekly. So it is an adverb. Last one, Outlook is a weekly magazine. Now your weekly is an adjective. It is describing more about the noun magazine. So this is the difference. The same words, in some place it is an adverb, in some places it is an adjective. So we need to understand whether that word is describing what, whether a noun or a verb. So I hope, dear children, that you have understood this lesson of adverbs. Now your homework is that you need to complete all these exercises in the textbook itself. And remember to please write neatly in the textbook. So thank you and have a very nice day.